Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans, y'all know me. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to this video. And as you know, NDI is extremely important for developing workflows for TriCaster. So today I want to talk to you about a new NDI tool called Screen Capture, which you can download for free right now at ndi.tv. And if you're familiar with NDI Scan Converter, Screen Capture has replaced it with all the features that you've been using. Now there are two versions of Screen Capture. NDI Screen Capture, which uses high bitrate NDI, and NDI Screen Capture HX, which uses NDI HX. Now what exactly does that mean? Well, NDI Screen Capture uses NDI to share your desktop and send it out as a full bit NDI signal. And NDI Screen Capture HX uses NDI HX, which takes advantage of the NVIDIA GPU on your system to put less demand on your computer CPU. Now, this is really important for gamers like myself who want to remove any demands from the CPU to keep the system moving as fast as it can be. Now, each of them have their own benefits in certain scenarios, so let's dig in and show you how it's done, son. So the first thing I want to show you is where to download the NDI Screen Capture application. You'll just need to go to ndi.tv, click on the NDI Tools at the top of the screen, then navigate down the page to the NDI Tools 4.5, which is the most current one as the time of I recorded this particular video. And then you'll go to NDI Tools for Windows, click on Download, follow the instructions, and you'll download the NDI Screen Capture application. Okay, so like I mentioned before, there are two different versions of it here, but let me show you how these work. So let's go to our Start menu and go down to our NDI Tools here. Ooh, went too far. Sorry about that. Helps if I learn how to spell right. There we go. So cool, you have two different versions of it here. One is going to be Screen Capture and then Screen Capture HX. And again, the Screen Capture, the regular version, will give you full NDI high bitrate broadcast of your screen, and then the Screen Capture will be the NDI HX version of it. So I'm already running this right now so that I can get my screen over to you guys. So let's take a look here. It's going to be down here at the bottom of the screen. And so you'll see that here, NDI Screen Capture. So let's right click on it and show you the different options available to you here. So the first thing you'll see is you're going to have an option to choose your frame rate depending on if you're in an NTSC or PAL region, or you can just use the monitor's built-in frame rate here. You can also go to your capture settings, and you can either capture just a region of interest, and then you can configure your region of interest from here as well. And then you also put a checkbox next to the mouse pointer, that way you can see what I'm doing here today. All right, and then you can also select the audio source from your device as well. Now, depending on what kind of system that you're running here, you might be able to send both the microphone off of, say, like your webcam, for example, or even just the system audio via that out. So keep in mind here, not only can you send out the video of your desktop, but you can also send out the webcam as well. Let's say you're on a laptop, for example, or you have a webcam like I have here. So you can send out two separate NDI feeds via NDI Screen Capture. All right, and then same thing with the webcam audio, you can send that out. And then also you can put a checkbox next to enable KVM control, and that will allow you to remotely control this particular system from, say, NDI Studio Monitor. All right, and then for more information, you can always go to ndi.tv. But let's go ahead and leave that alone, and I'm gonna fire up my PowerPoint presentation here, and let's go ahead and bring that into let's go ahead and bring that over into our TriCaster system. All right, so now here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and I want to grab the output of NDI Screen Capture that I'm broadcasting off of my desktop here. So let's go to input number one, click on the gear icon for that, and then under the source dropdown, select that, and then basically, we can go through and view all the different NDI feeds that are broadcasting on my network, which is coming off of my machine here, Richie Richie Rich. And I'm on my particular machine running two different monitors on there, so I can switch between either the first one or the second one, just depending on what you want to do here. So let me go ahead and just bring in my number one. All right, so now you'll see in my input number one, I now have a preview of the PowerPoint presentation that I was running over on my laptop, which is being shared via NDI and the power of NDI Screen Capture. All right, and now I can just go through and treat this like I would a normal video source. So for example, I can go and select input number one. as my program row, so we have that PowerPoint set up. And then I can say slide on my host real quick and bring him into the broadcast, and then just have them go through in their PowerPoint presentation and work that directly into my production, which is pretty dang awesome. Again, all via the power of NDI Screen Capture. Screen Capture, a fantastic refresh of an already fantastic tool. You can download it for free on NDI.tv. Again, please like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/NewTek Inc., for more NewTek nuggets of wisdom. For more information on NewTek products and services, talk to your local reseller or visit our website at newtek.com. And be sure to stay posted to newtek.tv for NewTek product announcements, interviews with NewTek users, third-party developers, and a whole lot more. Also, if you're using social media and posting some of your work on there, please use the hashtags NewTek or TriCaster. We'd love to see how people are using NewTek products to make their stories come to life. Thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on the next edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.